You agree with me that the Quran doesn't teach that the Bible has been changed, and the evidence supports the idea that the Bible hasn't been changed. So that means you should actually consider what the Bible is saying.
I'm just about to show him, and he says, I don't know.
If you knew, you would tell me.
I'm just about to show you.
I'm not allowed.
I'm not allowed. He says, show me. Then when I say I'm going to show him, he says, I'm not allowed.
So when you balance all this evidence up, you have to conclude that the Bible is trustworthy and the Quran is the one that is wrong.
No, he will come again in Islam, I know in about Islam.
Yeah. He's going to come back to you and correct you.
He will come Jesus again.
And correct you.
He will come Jesus again.
And correct
so he
you.
Will he will stay for 7 years, but the people said
he'll
7,
come and correct
7
you.
To 70. Yeah, and we have, he will, God, he will say the last. He will kill everyone. كل من عليها فان, everyone will be died.
Everyone.
ويبقى وجه ربك ذو الجلال والإكرام. And God will be there. That's when all the humanities will raise to God.
Okay.
Even the angels, even the who taken our breath, he will die himself as well.
Okay, so let me reply to that, because I think I'm going to try and have the kind of conversation with you that this guy was incapable of having.
Why?
Because you were rude. So in terms of the conversation, let us talk. So we've just seen in the Quran that the Quran claims that Allah is the first and the last.
Yeah.
We saw in the Bible, I read it as well,
yeah,
that Jesus claims to be the first and the last.
It's not.
So
don't lie.
Why is Allah stealing the divine titles of Jesus?
Sorry, what are you question?
Let me ask
so,
you.
So my point to you is, like, now you see, bro, this is a proper conversation.
No, I can't say you.
So, this is a proper conversation. So thank you for your respect. Yeah. So, in the Quran, Allah says he is the first and the last.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
In the Bible, Jesus says he is the first and the last. So why is Allah stealing...
Wait,
this is the question. Why is Allah stealing the divine titles of Jesus?
Well, there is problems for writing in the Bible. There wasn't... I don't know if it's still same Bible or if it's been like mistaken or something.
Let
I don't know. Okay. So what I know about Quran is... إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. We are... You know, and then the dhikr, I don't know how to say it in English, and we will protect the Quran.
The Quran,
I don't know about the Bible if the people in Christianity.
No, the Bible, it says that
same Bible.
I'll give them verse.
Or because there is books that disappeared. Other books have disappeared. We believe Bible. In Islam, to continue my religion, I have to believe the Bible, and I have to believe the old God boxes.
Yeah.
In my,
so
in my
so let me reply to that. Because you've got a whole bunch of problems there. Your first problem is, if the Bible has been corrupted, the Quran is false. Because the Quran says no one can change the words of Allah. No, 1 second, wait, I listen to you. Wait, I listen to you. So if I listen to you, you have to listen to me. Otherwise, we just start shouting like this guy again. Like, I want to talk to you because you're not, I don't think you're as rude as this man. So I want to have a conversation with you. If the Bible has been corrupted, the Quran is false, because the Quran claims that no one can change the words of Allah. Secondly, no, you're interrupting again. You're interrupting again. Why is it Muslims can't use manners in the park? Like, just constrain yourself. I listen to you, so you listen to me, so that we can have a conversation. So I'll say it again, okay? Bro, I left my water somewhere on the floor, could you bring it? Okay, so if the Bible has been changed, the Quran is false. Because the Quran says no one can change the words of Allah. The second thing that I would say to you is that we Christians don't believe about our book what you believe about your book. JC, let's move this way a bit. Let's move this way a bit. Come with me, bro. Okay. So, the Bible, we don't believe about our Bible what you believe about your Quran. If the Quran has been changed, which it has, your religion collapses. If in my religion we make a distinction about the message of the Bible and the text of the Bible, and if the text of the Bible has been changed, that isn't a knockdown thing for us. It isn't a KO blow for us. So I'm not inviting you to a religion like Islam, I'm inviting you to a different religion. And I would challenge you to show me a verse in the Quran that says that the Bible has been changed. Can you show me one?
No, there's no word in Quran says that the book is changed.
Brilliant. Yeah. So there's another bottle of water somewhere. I left it. Maybe someone's picked it up. Okay. So you agree with me that there's no verse in the Quran that says that the Bible has been changed. And you know that Muhammad himself was told to believe in the Quran, the Torah and the Injil.
We have to believe as well.
Right.
To continue my religion, Islam,
right. So the Torah and the Injil that existed in the 7th century, in the time of Muhammad, the one that Muhammad said he believed in, we have copies of that Torah and Injil. And it's the same one we're using today. In museums, you can go to the British Library and see them.
I don't have information about it.
Brother, let me have this conversation. Don't be rude. I'll talk to you afterwards if you want to talk. So, don't be rude. Let me talk to him. You just run away, bro. You ran away earlier, and if I came and speak to you, you'd run away again. So, well, shut up. So, because I'm trying to talk to him. So, what I'm trying to say to you, bro, is that if you take the Quranic witness seriously, the Torah and the Injil existed in the 7th century. And that 7th century document, we know what it looks like because the Assyrian church has it. The Assyrian church was the church that was active in the Arabian Peninsula. And so we can compare this Bible to the Bibles from the 7th century. And what we find is, it's the same. So the idea that the Quran teaches, you agree with me that the Quran doesn't teach that the Bible's been changed. And the evidence supports the idea that the Bible hasn't been changed. So that means you should actually consider what the Bible is saying. So when the Bible says that Jesus is the first and the last, you still have to address that.
How you mean it? The first and the last. Maybe the first and the last of the prophets will be the last.
Where does it
the
say
last prophet? Maybe it will be the last one, and when he died, it will be the last.
The last.
Because I don't know the meaning of the first and
where
the last.
Where does it say Jesus is the last and the first?
So let me.
Because it can
so
be
let
like
me,
different.
It says in the Bible. Where does
what it does mean first and
it
the last?
It says in the Bible.
So you asked me. You asked me to show you the context.
In the mouth. It doesn't know
so
you can't just
know. So let me show you.
Whatever evidence you see, you have to mention where it is.
Bro, I'm just about
first
to.
And last
you have to mention, you have to move.
I'm just about to.
Of the life,
if I say anything.
I'm just about to.
Listen to me, don't shout.
Right, listen. Listen.
If I say something, listen.
I'm just about to show you, bro. Do you see what I mean? They literally make a point and then don't listen to your answer.
Listen.
You asked me to show you. I'm just about to show you. I'm answering your question.
If you didn't
know. Oh my gosh. He says, if you don't know, I'm just about to show him.
Yes. No. I'm not waiting for you to show me.
Oh, I'm not waiting for you to show me.
Okay. You should know the verse.
You
should know that.
Are you listening? Have you heard that? This is how dumb Islamic arguments make you.
This is how dumb you are, man, because you don't know where this is.
Come here.
This is how dumb you are.
He says, I don't know. Yeah. I'm just about to show him and he says, I don't know.
If you knew, you would tell me.
I'm just about to show you.
You're not allowed.
I'm not allowed. He says, show me. Then when I say I'm going to show him, he says, I'm not allowed.
You don't know your
voice. Oh, my gosh. Are you listening? I'm going to show you.
I don't listen to you.
I don't listen to you.
Listen to me.
Do you see how stupid Islamic arguments.
You are a stupid dumb person, that's why I'm not listening
listen.
To you. I don't
so
listen
bro,
to Bible.
Let's listen to it in context. And as well as listening into context, I'll also answer his question because he asked me to show you.
No.
So, in Revelations, 22, let's move the camera back. Come this way, bro. Let him shout. Okay. So, in Revelations chapter 22, verses 12, 12 to 16. We're going to read it in context and we're going to see what it says. Now remember, the Quran says Allah is the first and the last. So that's the title. So now listen. Listen. See, I am coming soon. My reward is with me to repay everyone according to their works. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end. Now, what can come before the first? What can come before the first?
Nothing.
Yeah. What can come before the beginning?
Nothing.
Yeah. What can come after the last?
Nothing.
What can come after the end? Nothing. Who's that describing?
You mean Jesus?
But no, who is it describing? Who is the first and the last, that nothing can come before, nothing can come after? Who's that?
Jesus?
No, I'm asking you, who is that? Allah.
Allah, yeah.
Yeah, Allah, yeah, right. Blessed are those who wash their robes so that they will have the right to the tree of life and may enter into the city by the gates. Outside are the dogs and sorcerers and fornicators and murderers and idolaters and everyone who loves and practices falsehood. It is I, Jesus, who sent my angel to you with this testimony for the churches. So Jesus is speaking, and Jesus calls himself the first and the last, the beginning and the end, the Alpha and the Omega. And you agree, that is a description of God. So Jesus is calling himself God. And you agree that the Bible has not been changed. So if the Bible has not been changed and the Bible is calling Jesus God, then that means you should follow Jesus as your God.
I follow Jesus, but not like as God.
Not as God?
No. Like
so you don't follow the Injil?
Right?
You said that you need to believe in the Injil.
Well, you have the Injil. Christian way. I'm Muslim, so I know like what Jesus in my Islam way.
Yeah.
So you know it as a Christian because you're son of God and you believe in it like what the Bible tells. And we believe in Quran what it says about Jesus.
Okay, that's a completely fair statement. Yeah. So let me engage with that. So what you've said and what I recognize as being true is that the Quran describes Jesus in one way and the Bible describes Jesus in another way. And these two statements can't both be true. One of them has to be wrong because they're saying contradictory things. Well, one is saying that Jesus is
Christian
God.
Was before the Islam. So
thank
Islam
you.
Islam is the newer religion than Jewish and Islam. Right. So Christian is older. So I don't know if they keep the Bible
allow me to reply.
I'm not sure.
Okay, allow me to reply. I listen to
protect the Bible.
Allow me to reply.
Because there's other books that doesn't exist
okay,
anymore.
Allow me to reply, bro. Because I listen to what you have to say. So let's do a conversation. I can shout. I can do shouting. But I don't want to shout. I want to have a conversation. So, in terms of what the Quran says, the Quran says Jesus was just a man. The Bible says that Jesus was more than a man, he was God as well. So these two statements can't both be true. One of them has to be false. Now, agreed. But the Bible was written earlier by people that knew Jesus in Jesus' own time, in the first century. The Quran, in Jesus' own language, the language that he spoke, because Greek was the lingua franca of those people. So, in terms of the Quran was written 600 years later by someone who never knew Jesus, speaking in a totally foreign language, with no connection to Jesus at all. And not only that, the things that the Bible says about Jesus have witnesses outside of the Bible, Jewish and pagan historians who agree with what the Bible says about Jesus, but disagree with what the Quran says about Jesus. So when you balance all this evidence up, you have to conclude that the Bible is trustworthy and the Quran is the one that is wrong. How would you reply to that?
I have to research more.
That is totally fair answer.
More about the books, Bible, and the books. I have to research.
Okay. Yeah. Have you got a Bible?
I did read it in Arabic one time.
Okay.
All of it. Yeah.
Have you got a Bible now, though?
No, I don't have it.
I'd like to give you a gift. Okay. To begin your research, I want to give you a Bible. Yep. And go away, have a read of it yourself.
You give him a gospel?
Okay. No.
You're going to give him a real Bible?
Yeah. Wow. So there you go, bro. That's my gift to you. Thank you very much for a pleasant conversation. It's really lovely. Take some time to read that. And that what I would encourage you to do, bro, is to speak to a knowledgeable Christian about the questions you might have about that. Don't speak to a Muslim about what that says. Speak to a Christian about what that says. Find a knowledgeable Christian, and I'm happy to give you my email address. You can email me yourself, and I'll answer your questions. Yeah. Now, have you got a pen? Do you want to take down my email, or you want to record it on your phone? So drop me your questions there, and I'll do my best to talk to you about what you're reading that book.
Thank you, man.
Yeah. Really nice to speak to you. Really nice to speak to you, Mohammed. Real pleasure. Thank you so much.
God bless.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yeah, a little quick wrap, I think.
Finally? You want a little break? Because I see you.
Tell me if you don't have knowledge.
From one extreme to another.
Bro, you don't know. You have knowledge.
You have to. You don't have your own religion knowledge.
You don't have any knowledge.
Because you have to. You think something that's not correct.
How do you know that?
You just see money think that is not correct.
Where?
You see several things that wasn't correct.
Someone tells me you didn't even hear what I said.
You see one date. You see the date that wasn't correct. And another
thing
that you
said,
that Jesus said, I'm the first and I'm the last.
He did.
It is not correct.
Shall I show you?
No, listen to me. Listen to me. Don't open your book.
Why can't I open the book?
No,
you
have to
learn. Why are you scared of the Bible?
Why don't you remind it? Why don't you learn it?
Do you know the Quran?
If I say anything from Quran, I must know that.
So you know it?
This
you know
is God's word, I must know that.
So you
if
know
you
that.
Say regarding your book, so you must know that.
No, we're not Muslims. We're
so
better than Muslims. We're not
Muslims. Do you believe on God or not?
So,
do you believe in religion? It doesn't matter. You're Muslim, you're Christian, it doesn't matter. So as long as you believe on the God.
Yeah, here's where Jesus says.
Do you believe on God or not?
Yeah, we believe in one God.
I'm a Muslim, I believe on four books. Bible, Quran,
you don't
all
believe
of them.
In the Bible.
Of course
believe
I believe.
No, you don't. Sorry, we're at
the four. This is what you said. If I'm not, I don't believe on the
tell me one verse in the Bible.
Not the Bible.
It doesn't matter that I know.
Tell me one book in the Bible.
It doesn't matter that I know or not.
So you don't know
believe.
Anything. But you just said if you know something, you've got to say it from the book.
I believe.
So you said that you
believe. I
believe
on full God that is your from God.
Bro,
but
no,
if you,
bro,
if you
honestly, you're an ignorant man. You don't know what you're talking about.
Listen to me.
You don't know what you're talking about.
You just know just how to.
He's wasting your time.
Yes. Yes. He doesn't know what he's talking
this
about.
This man is waiting for you.
He doesn't know what he's talking about.
So this man is waiting for you.
So,
we don't wrap up for the previous discussion?
No, no, we're just starting.
All right, good. Cool. So what's the topic? The corruptibility of the Bible or?
What would you like to talk about?